Anatomy, cardiovascular system and heart vasculature. In this video, we are going to see the veins and the arteries and their circulatory function within the heart. But let's start from the arteries. The arteries supplying the heart are the famous coronaries. The arteries are named after the shape they create by surrounding the heart, a ring, or better, a crown. Arising from the left and right aortic sinus, the two coronaries are therefore called left and right coronary. In fact, it is the right aortic sinus that generates the right coronary, while the left aortic sinus generates the left one. But let's start from the right coronary, a very important artery. It comes out from the right sinus of Valsava, flows below the auricle of the right atrium, and then goes into the interventricular sulcus, also called coronary sulcus. It then bifurcates to supply the anterior part and a branch, the so-called acute margin, which supplies the right margin of the heart. Its most important branch is undoubtedly the posterior interventricular branch that you can see here in transparency. As the name suggests, the posterior interventricular branch goes through the posterior interventricular sulcus. The left coronary is a bigger artery that, as we already said, arises from the lower left aortic sinus before the auricle of the left atrium and then branches off into the anterior branch, also named the anterior interventricular branch, and, posteriorly, into the circumflex branch. As the name suggests, the anterior interventricular branch flows into the anterior interventricular sulcus and vascularizes especially the anterior wall of the heart. Instead, the circumflex branch flows posteriorly, giving off a branch to the obtuse margin. Between the terminal part of the left coronary and the branches of the right coronary, there is the anastomosis. With a wider network, the coronary veins all merge into the coronary sinus, a big vein that increases its caliber as it goes towards the posterior part. This big vein ends up directly inside the right atrium and takes advantage of the Thibetian valve, the valve of the coronary sinus. Only the last centimeter of this structure that you can see highlighted with a remarkable lumen can be considered the coronary sinus. The great cardiac vein is the thinnest part that you can see here highlighted. The great cardiac vein flows into the atrioventricular coronary sulcus and goes up to the anterior wall of the heart, where it gets a blood from the anterior interventricular branch. It also gets a branch called branch of the obtuse margin. Instead, from the left margin of the heart, the posterior interventricular artery, which flows through the intraventricular sulcus and the small cardiac vein and up directly in the coronary sulcus. Then the small cardiac vein, flowing into the coronary sulcus, takes the blood from the acute margin in the anterior part of the right atrium and ventricle. This video was created thanks to Anatomy Learning, an interesting free web app. The hyperlink can be found in the description. Instead, the text used for the concepts is Human Anatomy of Eddie Hermes. Thanks for watching.